फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कंटेंट कैसा लगा? ओके सो कॉन्टेस्ट कैसा लगा तुम्हें? कितना डिफिकल्ट था? ओके नाम ओके लेट्स स्टार्ट। सो पहले कॉन्टेस्ट का डिस्कस करेंगे। सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज लाइक दैट। सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन लाइक यू हैव गिवन अ टू पाइल्स ऑफ स्टोन। सपोज द फर्स्ट पाइल इज ए स्टोन्स, सेकेंड पाइल इज बी स्टोन। एंड सपोज ए इज ग्रेटर देन बी, सो इन वन मोर वी विल सब्ट्रैक्ट स्टोन, लाइक वी विल रिमूव स्टोन फ्रॉम द ग्रेटर पाइल, लाइक एज मेनी एज द सेकेंड अदर पाइल इज। ओके सो इन दैट केस in one operation then it will be like this a minus b and b. Okay, and we will go on doing it. Suppose now d is greater than a minus b, so now it will be a minus b. Like suppose b is greater than a minus b, so b minus a minus b. Okay, so we will go on doing this. So at the end one pile become empty and the other one has some stone. Okay, so we have to find this x number. So if you remember, this is actually the property of GCD. Okay, GCD of A comma B is same as GCD of A minus B comma B. Okay, so like from bigger to lower. Okay, like it is exactly what you used to do like in the Euclidean GCD method. Okay, like it is, if you go on subtracting from bigger one, it is basically it is like that. Okay, like the remainder of this thing. Okay. And at the end, one of them will become zero, and the other one is actually GCD. So that's the answer. Like the answer is GCD of two numbers. Okay, just a second actually. Any doubts? Kuch bhi doubt hai? So I think this is a good outcome. Okay. Like ये क्वेश्चन क्लियर है ना? सबको किसी को कुछ डाउट है कभी? जीसीडी like the answer is basically GCD. Okay, GCD of two numbers. Okay, so like in this question, you have to like there are Q queries, and the Q queries and in each query you have given two numbers L and R. Okay, obviously it is written. So you have to find the sum of like. So you have to find this for each x, okay, each x starting from L to R, okay, you have to find the sum, okay. So dx basically the number of, okay, so number of divisors of x, okay. So I think this is the question, find the sum of number of divisors of the numbers, okay. So one thing that evident, like we have to, if you find dx for each x, okay, like d1 then d2 and so on to be like some bigger number like n, which is 10^6. I think L and R has range from 10^6, right? And we do the prefix sum, and then each query can be answered in O of 1 then, okay. So after that you can answer each query in O of 1, right? Now the question is how to find these values, okay. So there are two methods, okay. First one is easy one, which is the square root method, root n method. So you iterate over root n loop and find the count of dx, okay. So like find for x, to count find dx you require root x computation, okay. Second one is, which is the much more optimized method than this one, which is the sieve method, okay. I think this spelling is incorrect, which is sieve method. So like you run the loop of this sieve and maintain the count of divisors, okay. Let me show you this thing. So you just make one bigger number, okay, which is, assume that this is 26 or something like something bigger, okay, 1 26, bigger 1 6. Okay. So first method, what you do for each loop. For each one, you can do this kind of thing. Okay, this is one method. I think you all are familiar with this one. So if j divides this one, so one factor is j, other factor is I by j, right? So this will give us like I plus 2. But if this is a perfect square, then we have to subtract 1, right? So in this way you can find all this method. So the time probability for this one is basically the root 1 plus root 2 plus up to root 10^6, okay, which is kind slightly less efficient, okay. And the second one is square root 1 method, okay. Like this is one method. Second one is method one. The another method is to change sieve little bit. Okay, so first of all, you just set array to 0, like complete array is 0. Then you run this sieve loop, okay, like this. Now here j is divisible by I, right? So that means I can just increase this one, okay. So now at the end I have dj count, okay, like what is the value of, like number of divisors. Okay, so this one is much efficient because the complexity for this will be n by 1 plus n by 2 plus n by n, okay, which is approximately n log n. And then you can do prefix sum and you can answer the niche query in OAuth 1. Okay. Is it clear or it's doubt? इस प्रॉब्लम में किसी को डाउट है क्या? ओके, सेकंड मेथड इज बेसिकली टू चेंज द सीयू मेथड. ओके, लाइक यू नो द सीयू मेथड, राइट? लाइक यू कैन फाइंड द प्राइम्स एंड ऑल दिस थिंग. सो इन द सेकंड मेथड व्हाट टू डू, दीज आर द लूप ऑफ सीयू. ओके, सो यू इट, दिस इज द फर्स्ट नंबर एंड इन द सेकंड वे rooted over all the multiples of I. Okay, see, like I am incrementing this I, j with I. So that means j is divisible by I, right? So that means that means j has a divisor I. So I can directly increment this value. Okay. And the competitive for this one will be like, if you see, it is n by 1, n by 2, because I run for n by times. Okay, like it is actually the summation of n by I, because we are running only till the j reaches n, and j incrementing I in each like in each iteration. Okay. Any doubt? Kisi kuch puchna ho? वन मोर थिंग जो आई थिंक काफी लोगों को नहीं पता है, लाइक मिस्टेक ये इस पर लाइक डाउट में भी हमने देखा है. तो लाइक इफ यू आर डिक्लेयरिंग समथिंग अरे, लाइक सपोज आई एम डिक्लेयरिंग दिस अरे, इफ यू आर सेट टू जीरो, ओके, दिस डजंट मीन लाइक डी अरे इज जीरो, लाइक ऑल एंट्रीज इन डी अरे जीरो. Entries in D array zero. Okay, so it will only set only first entry to zero. Okay, this is the one thing. Okay, if you declare array globally, it will automatically set this particular all entries in this particular array to zero, or like all the global variables. Okay, if you see like in I, J, all the global variable will be zero. Okay, like jo bhi globally declare karoge, so automatically जीरो से इनिशियलाइज हो जाएगा, बट नॉट इन लोकल. ओके, लोकल में वो रैंडम वैल्यूज देंगे. सो दिस पर्टिकुलर ओनली सेट्स ओनली फर्स्ट एंट्री ऑफ द अरे, लाइक डी जीरो टू जीरो, एंड रिमेनिंग एंट्रीज आर रैंडम. ओके, सो टू सेट ऑल द एंट्रीज टू जीरो, वन मेथड इज टू लूप ओवर कंप्लीट अरे एंड सेट टू जीरो, बट दिस इज नॉट गुड मेथड. ओके, लाइक टाइम लगता है. ओके, सेकेंड मेथड इज to do memset. Okay, like memset. Okay, so what exactly memset do? Okay, like iska ek documentation hai, but ek brief idea ke liye main bata dunga ki memset can only able to set zero and minus one. Okay, zero and minus one only, bas ye do value set kar sakta hai. Like if you try to do this thing like memset d2, okay, it won't work. Okay, like ये कुछ और वैल्यू देगा, बिकॉज दिस सेकंड प्लेस रहता हूँ काइंड ऑफ वो डिफरेंट रहता है. लाइक इसका मीनिंग एक्चुअली इंट रहता है, एक्चुअली अनसाइन इंट रहता है, कुछ अलग मीनिंग रहता है. ओके, सो लाइक एक ब्रीफ ओवरव्यू के लिए एक बता दूंगा, लाइक मेन सेट सिर्फ जीरो और माइनस वन सेट कर सकता हूँ. सो इट इज गुड टू यूज दिस मेथड, नॉट दिस. ओके, दिस इज इनकरेक्ट. Yeah, it also not sure actually, मैं बता नहीं सकता, but I think it also initialize. Okay, like local में कुछ नहीं होता, like local में तुम ऐसा भी करोगे then also it doesn't mean like वो zero initialize कर देगा. Okay, I think अभी जो C++ 17 या 19 से ये चीज होती है, but okay, like I'm not sure. Okay, but safe side, this method won't initialize to zero. Okay, globally everything is already zero, so it's good. Okay, but like I'm not sure globally ye cheez kya karta hai, but local mein to like this method won't work. Okay, like ye jo bhi method hai ye kaam nahi karti hai, but if it is kind of this one. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so this will initialize the array to this particular part. Okay, like 1, 2, 3, 4. This is correct. But doing this thing, what expect that like wo sare elements ko zero kar dega, or like this one or one. Okay. This is incorrect. Okay, I am not sure कि globally ये चीज कैसे काम करती है, but like locally तो नहीं होता इतना quite sure. काफी लोगों ने like same quarters में wrong answer डाले, मैं देखा था. Okay, now second one. Third one. Okay, so in that question, you are given n numbers and you have to find the number of sub arrays with sum divisible by n. Okay, so again, because we have to find the number of sub arrays divisible by n, so suppose this is some array. Okay, and suppose this particular sub array from I to j is divisible by like ai plus 1 plus aj, is divisible by n. Okay, like consider it as congruence modulo 0 mod n. Okay, if so, what exactly it means? Okay, it means like sum from 0 a1 aj minus sum from aj a1 plus a minus, okay, is zero mod, right? Okay, like jo age condition hai, like when I equal to 0, then what will happen? Wo like wo main consider nahi karwa, to wo different handle karna padega. I'm just try to consider general case, okay, like not age case. Okay, so if you see this, that is basically equivalent to sum of x from 0 to j aj congruent to sum of, okay, like x, okay, sum of y from 0 to I minus 1 a minus 1 mod. That means these two term will give same remainder when we divide it by n. Okay, so like it is kind of like doing the prefix modulo kind of thing. Okay, like I can store the prefix modulo value with respect to n. Okay, and suppose now I want to find the number of sub arrays which is divisible by n and ending at j. Okay, so for that I only have to find the number of I such that prefix of I minus 1 has exactly same values as prefix of j. Okay, so like if we can say that like prefix of j is basically the sum of x from 0 to j aj mod. So I have to find only the number of i's, like of the prefix, the like number of sub arrays ending at j divisible by n is equals to number of i's such that I minus 1, like prefix of I minus 1, as exactly equals l, equal value to prefix of j. Okay, so बस ये चीज़ मैं पर count पता करना था and that's it. Okay, like अगर तुम इसका code भी simple है, but like you can maintain math something kind of thing. Okay, or a automatic check running sum maintain kar sakte ho. Okay, like if you are here to take like current element input liya and the running sum will be running modulo sum will be this one and like answer is equal to plus of sum. कितने नंबर ऑफ प्रीफिक्सेस है जो इससे एंड हो रहे हैं. ओके, लाइक वन एज कंडीशन में भी लाइक 0 का 1 है. लाइक इफ यू कंसीडर 0 लेंथ सब अरे व्हिच इज इनिशियली इट इज ओके लाइक इट एग्जिस्ट सो व्हिच हैज 1, सो वी हैव टू इनिशियलाइज विद दिस 1 लाइक 0 मॉडुलो सब अरे लाइक इज 0 लेंथ सब अरे. ओके, एंड लाइक एट द एंड जस्ट इंक्रीमेंट इट विद प्लस 1. ओके, दैट्स इट. बस कितना ही करना था एंड प्रिंट आंसर, बिकॉज सपोज द array from 0 to I is divisible by n. So prefix of I minus prefix of minus 1. Okay, minus 1 is doesn't seem correct. Okay, so to minus 1 prefix of minus 1 as a 0 consider kar sakte ho. Okay, like minus 1 ka value is 0, take minus 1. So in that case, it is 1. Okay, because वो exist करता है and remaining आते like same. कुछ कुछ doubt इस problem में इस problem. किसी को कुछ डाउट नहीं है. लेट्स अनदर प्रॉब्लम. कुछ पूछना तो पूछ लो. लाइक इसलिए डिस्कशन सेशन बोल रही. ओके, तो बेसिकली सपोज अज्यूम करो कि सर्वर फ्रॉम आई टू जे इज डिविजिबल बाय एन. ओके, इनका सम डिविजिबल बाय एन, दैट मींस ए आई प्लस वन टू ए जे इज जीरो बॉड है. ओके, that means ye zero remainder deta jo n se divide kiya. Okay, this sum is exactly same as prefix sum from 0 to j minus prefix sum from 0 to I minus 1. Okay, so that means again that difference like divisible by n, right? So which is again same as ki ye jo particular sum rahega from 0 to j and this particular sum from 0 to I minus 1, they will give same modulo when we divide it by n. Okay, so suppose I have pre-computed this, like prefix, if I pre-computed this prefix part, prefix of j is basically sum from 0 to j, usko n se divide karne ke baad jo remainder aayega wo. Okay, so now if I want to find the number of servers which is divisible by n and which ends at j. Okay, so iske liye mujhe basically kya pata karna padega ki kitne I hai jiska if jiska remainder like prefix I minus 1 value is same as prefix j value. Okay, बस मुझे ये काउंट पता करना है. तो ये एक्चुअली मैं मेंटेन कर सकता हूँ बाय यूजिंग मैप और समथिंग. ओके, लाइक इस मैप स्ट्रक्चर में मेंटेन कर सकता हूँ, राइट? सो बेसिकली मैं अभी क्या कर रहा हूँ, ये जो सम जो वैल्यू रहेगा वो बेसिकली काइंड ऑफ प्रीफिक्स जे है. ओके, लाइक इट इज काइंड ऑफ प्रीफिक्स जे बिकॉज ये रनिंग सम चल रहा है, राइट? ये रनिंग प्रीफिक्स काउंट चल रहा है एंड वॉट हैव टू डू, आई जस्ट हैव टू फाइंड दिस, इसका काउंट कितने i माइनस 1 से, लाइक जिसका सेम रिमाइंडर रहेगा मतलब जब डिवाइड करेंगे. सो दैट मींस उतने मुझे i माइनस 1 की काउंट मिल गए. सो दैट मींस फ्रॉम i टू j इट विल बी डिविजिबल बाय n. ओके, जो मुझे श्योर शॉर्ट पता. ओके, एंड नाउ फॉर फ्यूचर i's. ओके, लाइक जो अभी आगे जाके जो i's जाएगी वो इसको कंसिडर कर, इसलिए मैं इसमें इसको इंक्रीमेंट कर रहा हूँ मैप में. ओके, लाइक जो अभी अभी फ्यूचर में इस पर्टिकुलर से, लाइक अभी मेरे काउंट में इससे एंड होने वाले स्टोर हो गए बट फ्यूचर में इससे स्टार्ट होने वाले काउंट हो, इसलिए मैं इसको इंक्रीमेंट करूंगा. ओके, दैट्स इट. ओके, लाइक अगर ये समझा नहीं तो मैं ऐसे भी एक्सप्लेन कर सकता हूँ. ओके, लेट मी एक्सप्लेन दिस. Store it in this way, like n plus 1 and the prefix of 0. Like मैं यहाँ पे assume करो कि 0 index चल रहा हूँ and there is map which maintains count and because 0 index है तो ये वाला part plus plus कर दिया. Now I move to 1. I take first input. Okay, so which is first input. Now मैंने current prefix value count किया which is like kind of prefix of I minus 1 plus a percent. Okay, prefix modulo count kiya. Now number of server is ending at I which is divisible by sum is divisible by n is basically mujhe for j, suppose mujhe j pe end hone server is pata karne hain jo n se divisible ho, basically mujhe aise i's pata karne hain जिसका प्रीफिक्स i माइनस 1, प्रीफिक्स मॉडुलो ऑफ i माइनस 1, मॉडुलो प्रीफिक्स ऑफ i माइनस, लाइक टिल i माइनस 1, वो सेम हो जे तक का. ओके सो ये चीज बिकॉज आई इज लेस देन जे, आई इज लेस, आई कैन लेस देन जे, तो आई माइनस वन हैज टू बी लेस देन जे. ओके तो ये काउंट में मैप में मेंटेन कर रहा हूं. So that means my answer will basically prefix of I. Okay, like okay, like अगर थोड़ा कंफ्यूज हो रहा था मैं इसको j कर दे रहा हूँ j. Okay, and like अभी मुझे ये जो काउंट मुझे दे दिया कि number of suburbs ending at j which divisible by n. Okay. बट अभी यहाँ पे मैं एंडिंग वाला काउंट तो मैंने पता कर लिया, बट मुझे स्टार्टिंग वाला भी चाहिए तो जो फ्यूचर में कहीं तो भी आएगा, राइट? तो इसलिए मैं इस पर्टिकुलर काउंट को प्लस प्लस कर दूंगा. ओके अभी क्लियर है क्या? बिकॉज लाइक जो सबर डिवाइड रहेगा वहां का प्रीफिक्स तक का आई माइनस वन, आई माइनस वन का प्रीफिक्स मॉडल हो और जे तक का प्रीफिक्स मॉडल हो सेम रहेगा. यही पॉइंट है, मुझे बस अगर जे तक एंड वाले पता करने, जे तक एंड वाला नंबर ऑफ सबर है, तो बेसिकली मुझे इनका काउंट पता करना पड़ेगा जो जिसका जे के बराबर मॉडल होगा. दिस इज आई कैन स्टोर दैट थिंग इन मैप. ओके लाइक वही यहाँ पे कर रहा हूँ मैं, प्रीफिक्स मॉडल और रनिंग प्रीफिक्स मॉडल मेंटेन कर रहा हूँ. ओके एंड लाइक ये पर्टिकुलर चीज देगा नंबर ऑफ आईज, नंबर ऑफ आई जो जिसका आई माइनस वन सेम है यहाँ के जे से. ओके एंड वो लेस देन बिकॉज फ्यूचर वाले अभी तक मैप में एड नहीं किया, राइट? तो अभी तक जो मैप में करंट है वो प्रीवियस स्टेट के ही है, राइट? तो अब मुझे जे फ्यूचर में काउंट है इसलिए मैं इसको आप इंक्रीमेंट कर दूंगा. शिवम समझाए क्या? हेलो शिवम, हेलो जीव, जरा समझाया क्या? क्लियर है क्या अभी? ओके द नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम. ओके आई थिंक शिवम कॉल में. नेक्स्ट वन इज लार्जेस्ट. ओके सो ये पर्टिकुलर प्रॉब्लम, सो तुम्हें दो अरे गिवन है. You are given A0, then A1 and up to A1, right? And like you are also given second array which is B0, B1 and Bn minus. Okay. So your task is to find the largest k such that if you consider a particular subarray, okay, like particular subarray, let it be like this one. सर्वर है दिस पर्टिकुलर सर्वर है. सो दिस कॉस्ट विल बी लेस देन सी. ओके लाइक विल बी विदिन सी. ओके सो यू हैव टू फाइंड द लार्जेस्ट के सच दैट देयर एग्जिस्ट वन सम पर्टिकुलर सर्वर है. सो दिस इज एक्चुअली कॉस्ट ऑफ दिस सर्वर. ओके you can say that in this way I plus k minus 1 to I. Okay. So that there exists the subarray of size k whose cost will be less than equal to c. Okay. So you have to find such k, largest k, like as a subarray exists karega. Okay. Now okay. So kuch idea ki kaise karenge is problem ko? Kuch observations. Like, anyone has any observation? Like some basic observation start. Like, so one observation that you can C is there, which is the like very obvious one, I think. Is that suppose I fix like if I fix R, okay? So cost of starting from I to R, okay? So this is cost from R plus K minus 1 to I, okay? This is a cost. Suppose this is a cost function, okay? So cost of I to I, we do obviously is an equal to cost of R to I plus 1. Will be obviously then equals to cost of, because this size of server is increasing, okay, with increase in the endpoint, this one will increase, this part sum is also going to increase because each AI has a positive number, okay, like constantly, okay, each AI has a positive number, okay, and this max value can't be taken, like it will either the same or like it will increase, okay. So that means with increasing the endpoint, this cost will go into increase. Okay, that's the first observation. Okay, cost of R to M. Okay, like something like that. Second one. So based on this observation, we can say that for each server, like for each server starting from I, like. Server A starting from I, which is like I plus K minus 1. So with increasing K, this cost will increase, right? For each server A, right? So that means suppose for some particular value of K, let it be K1, okay? Let me frame in this way. So you can see that like with increasing value of K, the cost of server starting from particular index will going to increase, right? So these are the observation because like all are positive numbers and K is also a positive number, okay? And so this is kind of a monotonic function. If you see like with increasing K, the cost is also increasing for all K length servers, right? So this will give us something kind of hint of binary search kind of structure, okay? So for some mid value, if I can able to find such subarray whose cost is less than equal to C, so that means I have to go in the upper direction because it is a monotonic function. Okay, if you say it is a monotonic function, okay. So now the question is how to check whether there is a subarray with cost less than equal to C of size mid, okay. So there are many ways to do that. Okay. So first one is we have to find this sum, right? So this sum we can easily find by using prefix sum, right? This is kind of nothing but we can find it using prefix sum, like prefix of I minus prefix of I plus K minus 1 minus 2. Okay. So this is done. Okay. Now let me for fixed value of K, we can find this in off on by using prefix sum. Now the question is how to find this particular value. Okay, so there are different ways to find this value. One is using set multiset, like one multiset sliding window, like ek window ko slide karte jao, because the window is of fixed length made, okay, like k fixes, so that means the window is also fixed, okay, and then to previous element ko delete karte jao and then new element ko add karte jao. The second one is to use DQ technique, okay, like DQ trick, like that we discussed, I think, earlier, like in the first week, I think. So the second one is to use this DQ trick, like you can find, because multiset will take like logarithmic amount of time to like insert and delete, okay, but DQ like will give the like maximum in the particular window, you know, off on, okay. So you can use this trick also, okay. So now we know the for each window, we know the like maximum. We can find this thing also, and we know this thing also because this is a fixed one. And now for each subarray of size k, which is fixed as mid, you can find the cost. If you could able to find one such subarray whose cost is less than equal to C, so then we will return true. So that is our check function in binary search. Okay. Any doubts? Could be doubt is there is okay. Concept mein kuch doubt hai kisi ko? एक्चुअली बाइनरी सर्च क्यों अप्लाई कर रहे हैं? लाइक जब भी कोई भी चीज लाइक मोनोटोन दिखे, लाइक सपोज लाइक एनीथिंग दैट वी फाइंड लाइक देयर आर टू पैरामीटर्स एंड विद द इंक्रीज इन वन पैरामीटर वी सपोज वी फाउंड वी आल्सो फाउंड फाइंड द इंक्रीज इन द सेकंड पैरामीटर इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज एनीथिंग ओके सो लाइक सो देन लाइक अप्लाई बाइनरी सर्च ओके लाइक वो वही बाइनरी सर्च का ट्रिक रहता है लाइक इफ देयर इज सम पैरामीटर एक्स एंड अदर पैरामीटर वाई so with increase in x if you find some parameter with constantly increasing or like decreasing just apply binary search okay kuch doubt hai kisi ko actually okay so there is one thing also like अगर सपोज सर्वर एग्जिस्ट नहीं करता लाइक इवन द सिंगल सिंगल लेंस सर्वर इज आल्सो नॉट सफिशिएंट टू लिमिट द कॉस्ट ओके लाइक जो सी के अंदर कॉस्ट ओके सो इन दैट केस द आंसर विल बी जीरो राइट बिकॉज जीरो लेंस सर्वर हैज कॉस्ट जीरो एंड सी इज ग्रेटर देन जीरो एक्चुअली ऑलवेज ग्रेटर देन जीरो देयर वन थिंग दैट आई वांट टू कवर इज दैट So I went through some course. Okay, so like Karthik, like your logic is, I think, completely different. Okay, like you max there it. Okay, so which is not good because you are taking max from you are taking prefix max. Okay, which is not what exactly the question asks for us. Like we have to find the max in particular server. Okay, and the another one, Amisha, your logic is completely correct, but with one thing. Okay, like you have to see like you have to. So basically, you are initializing with low is zero. Okay, so when suppose all elements are zero, like suppose all elements are one, and this C is and C is also one. Okay, suppose C is zero. Okay, or suppose all elements are two and C is one. Okay, so there is no subarray with yes. Suppose all elements are two and C is one. Okay, so there is no subarray. With positive length, with cost less than equal to zero. Okay, so that my answer is zero in this case. Okay, so if you see, you are initializing low with zero. That is completely fine, but like your logic doesn't allow to do that thing because you are doing here ax minus one. So if your x, which is your mid actually, if your mid is zero, so it will access the negative index, right? So again, so this is not actually good. Okay. So also d dot front okay you are accessing d dot front because dq is empty actually dq me kuch add nahi hua so dq will be empty so it will return actually something garbage value okay so you have to only remove this condition like make it one and default value of answer to zero then your code will pass okay and other I think other like बाकी लोगों ने like kind of silly mistakes से किया but I don't know. I think we need to कुछ और code submit कर दो कुछ doubt है logic में कि anyone has any doubt कुछ भी doubt हो anything like you find like one is increasing with one other parameter or all decreasing so just apply binary search okay Yeah,
you can. So I am asking that if this like this question will with this constant will pass the set solution.
Okay, I am not sure about that, but you can try that. Okay, you can try.
Okay.
My like the solution that I tried also uses DQ.
Yeah, I tried DQ.
Okay, so you can try that because. If you use set which actually add one logarithmic extra complexity because like then your complexity will be like kind of O of n log n this is using DQ but if you are using set then also add one log n extra okay. So it is always better to go for optimal one but But you can try that thing also. I think it will pass. Okay. Any other doubt? Okay. The next problem. Okay. So in this problem, you have given an array like A0, A1, A2, A minus. Okay. So you have to find some for all I from 0 to N minus 1, for all J 0 to N minus 1, to find some of these things, AI by AJ. This is floor, okay? Floor value. I think it's correct. Yeah, I and J can be anything. Okay. So now question is how to solve this problem. So first of all, like write down some basic observation that you can find, okay? So first thing, like if AI is less than AJ, then there is no meaning to do this thing because it will give zero answer, right? So based on this observation, now we can deduce that like if you sort the array in increasing order, okay? Like we sort the array like A0, A1, okay? Now suppose it's a sorted array, okay? And now the question is, we can now reduce the question in this way. Like I from 0 to N minus 1, J from I to N minus 1. We have to find AJ by AM. Okay, like take it up AJ by AM for simplicity. Okay, AJ by AI. So because AJ is greater than AI, because J is starting from I, AJ is always going to be greater than equals to AI because this is sorted array, right? So now the question reduces to this part. Now AJ is greater than, find this sum. Okay. So we are remove the, our wasted part of the sum. Now third thing is that the constraints, okay? Like, see the constraints. So if you can see the constraint on AI is like it is within the tensor 5, okay? Like the constraint is tensor 5. So there are two things. So the constraints are halka sa idea like kaun se direction mein sochna, okay? Because suppose AI is like kind of tensor 9 or something. So it's kind of like you have to do something generalized kind of thing. But it is given that AI is around into tensor 5. So that means you can store AI in kind of array because you can declare the array of set tensor 6 or tensor 5 in the code because the time limit allows us to do that. Okay? So that means like you have to do something with the some kind of manipulation with the some array. Okay? The other thing is that like if there are multiple integers of the same value. Yeah, right. Yeah. So basically, so you have to do something kind of array kind of manipulation. Okay. The other thing is that suppose I fix I. Okay. Like suppose I fix the number. Okay. Like if I fix the lower number. Okay. AI. Okay. So if you can see that, like, all the numbers belonging to x m and x m minus 1, all the numbers belonging to this particular part has equal floor value, which is m, right? All the numbers, the count of numbers belonging to this range has equal floor value, right? Which is m, right? So based on this observation, like, you can now kind of deduce that, yes, because if I iterate over m, which is multiple of like x, so kind of find the like this value, okay? So iterating over this m part, okay, like iterating over the multiples, okay, this gives us the hint of c. Okay, again, wrong screen. It is give us a hint of c, okay, like we have to use some kind of like c part, okay? So how we can use this c? So let me show it code, okay? So one thing is that declare one big array, count array, okay, initialize with 0 using memset, not the other trick, like the other like not like this, okay? Initialize with memset, or you can loop over it, whatever you want. So what is count array? Okay, like this basically stores the count of occurrence of particular value. Okay, like, okay, suppose you declare n, so you just, yeah, so basically it will store the count of particular occurrence. Okay, now how it will be useful, like iska kaam kya hai? Okay, so like directly jump to the main part. Okay, so go to this part. So now I am iterating over the multiples of I. Okay, I am iterating over the multiples of I. So that means the array starting from j and ending at j plus I minus 1 will have the same. So that means all the number between the, like, all x between start and end gives same floor value. Okay, like, how to say that, floor value of what, x by I. Okay, so this will give us same value of floor x by I, right? Because so it will give the same value of floor of x by I. And what that value is, that value is basically the j by I, right? So I know that, like, all the numbers starting from start to end has same floor value. Okay, now my question is, I want to find how many numbers are. So basically what I'm doing here, I'm fixing the like denominator part of the fraction. Okay, I'm finding the count of the like numerator numerator part. Okay, so now so this is a fixed part, right? So now question is, how many numbers are there which belongs from this particular end? Okay, so how to find it? So where this count array is, like, you find this count array is useful. Okay, so you can do now the prefix count. Okay, so now you can maintain one prefix count. So this is basically just count of I equals to prefix count of I minus 1 plus count of I. Okay, so you maintain one prefix count. Now you can find the number of elements between start and end using the prefix count. Okay, so let this num is prefix count of n minus prefix count of start minus 1. Now you know the number of elements which belongs, which has value, like the elements which has values between start and end. Okay, so that's it. Okay, now my answer will be like kind of this one, f into how many numbers are there. Okay, one other thing is that this is not complete. Okay, now I know the number of elements which gives same value when denominator is equal to r, like, okay, but there can be multiple occurrence of same r, right? So here we also need to multiply with count, like number of occurrence of value y in the array. ये समझ आएगा कि कुछ डाउट है मुझे तो व्हाई वी आर डूइंग प्रीफिक्स काउंट व्हाई वी आर डूइंग हाउ वी आर यूजिंग सीयू ट्रिक हियर because we are iterating only multiple, like so it can fix this start and end. And how predict font is useful now, like kuch doubt hai kisi ko solve like jitne bhi code dekha, I think most of the people forget this count hai, okay, like ye multiply karna bhul gaya to isko matlab like ये ट्रिक था उसने एक्चुअली का कुछ डाउट है इसमें कुछ भी पूछना है कि कैसे हो रहे लाइक सपोज मैं डिनोमिनेटर का वैल्यू फिक्स कर दिया व्हिच इज आर एंड नाउ आई एम ट्राइंग टू फाइंड द आंसर विद रिस्पेक्ट टू लाइक न्यूमरेटर ओके सो मैंने यहाँ पे डिनोमिनेटर का वैल्यू फिक्स कर दिया आर जो कि काउंट है नंबर्स का है एरे में एंड नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज लाइक टू इटर एक्स ओके So now we are finding the like the number of count of numbers in between the start and end points like jiske beech mein same floor rahega kuch doubt hai kisi mein is context mein kuch doubt hai aur kuch puchna hai is paanchwe question mein kuch puchna hai AR minus 1 by AR will give us the like the upper bound of like the max value of floor value. Okay, like floor value से बड़ा जा नहीं सकता, right? Perfect, right? Then how you can like I'm not getting like ये कैसे रहेगा? Yeah, okay.
Hello. हाँ, so मैंने क्या किया कि एक हर एलिमेंट के लिए मतलब एरे पे आइट्रेट किया आई से, so m की वैल्यू a ऑफ n माइनस वन अपॉन a ऑफ i, मतलब कि ये मैक्सिमम हमको फ्लोर वैल्यू मिल सकती है क्योंकि a ऑफ n माइनस वन इज द मैक्सिमम एलिमेंट. अब एक वेरिएबल है j वन से लेके m तक आइट्रेट करता है, तो फिर एरे में जो मैक्सिमम वैल्यू होगी जिसके लिए एक पर्टिकुलर जे मिल सकता है उसके लिए लोअर बाउंड यूज किया, मतलब ए ऑफ आई इंटू जे प्लस वन उसका लोअर बाउंड लिया ए में, तो फिर उतने एलिमेंट्स मिल जाएंगे जो कि उस वो पर्टिकुलर फ्लोर वैल्यू देंगे.
ओके वन थिंग लाइक यहाँ पे क्लियर मिस्टेक मुझे दिख रहे हैं कि suppose all elements are 1 1 1 1 1 and last one 10^6 okay to ye particular value ke liye tumhare paas m 10^6 ho jayega right to ye obviously clearly dena chahiye but I think this part mein aur kuch aur so basically this will definitely give clearly ye samjhana kyun kyunki kya miss ho raha hai but the question is you are getting wrong answer. Okay, so I think lower bound is not use upper bound. I think upper bound say dena chahiye but
a of i 10 to the power 5 तक है.
Okay, so like, so 10^5 ले लो इसको. So like my point is that for each i up to this last one, n minus 1 तक, तुम्हारा m 10^5 रहेगा, right? So you are iterating 10^5 times this n minus 1, which is also in the range of 10^5 or 6, something like that. So which will definitely give a TLA, okay? But your code is giving wrong answer. I think there is another mistake. Okay, so ek kaam karo tum like ye question forum mein puch lo. I will look into like book. ओके मैं वहां पे देखूंगा. ओके
ओके थैंक्स.
फोर पे पूछ रहा आई थिंक इट शुड बी अपर बाउंड आई थिंक बट ओके मैं तो अच्छे देखूंगा एक बार चेक कर लो कि अपर बाउंड लोअर बाउंड होना चाहिए.
अपर बाउंड से आंसर नहीं आ रहा था लोअर बाउंड से आ रहा था.
ओके तो फोरम में एक बार पूछ लो वहां पे देखते हैं ऑलरेडी रनिंग. और किसी को कुछ डाउट है कुछ पूछना है और लाइक अगर तुम्हारा कोड तुम्हें लगता है सही है एंड देन वो पास नहीं करा तो लाइक यू कैन ऑलवेज आस्क ऑन द फोरम. This is another problem. So like you have to do this kind of manipulation. Okay, like एक observation रखो then try to do then से कुछ conclusion निकालने की कोशिश करो like जैसे यहाँ से sort करना था and then उसको थोड़ा simplify करो and then look at the constraints. Okay, and then again कुछ सोचो कि कैसे जाएगा like इनके बीच में सेम वैल्यू रहेगा. ओके सो इफ आई कैन फिक्स द वैल्यू तो एंड बिकॉज टेंस ऑफ फाइव रेंज में जाए यहाँ पे कंस्टेंट का भी यूज आता है कि लाइक मैं उसका फ्रीक्वेंसी स्टोर कर सकता हूँ एंड लाइक देन लुकिंग एट दिस पर्टिकुलर पार्ट लाइक एक्स एम एक्स एम प्लस वन बाई इनका वैल्यू सेम रहेगा लाइक सो वी डोंट नीड टू इट ओवर द मिडल एलिमेंट. ओके तो वो तो हमें सीव का आइडिया देता है. ओके सो दिस शुड बी द अप्रोच. ओके इससे फिर काफी टफ प्रॉब्लम भी हो जाती है अगर तुम इस पर्टिकुलर अप्रोच सोचोगे. ओके सो लाइक दिस प्रॉब्लम यू हैव गिवन थ्री वेक्टर्स व्हिच कैन बी लाइक काइंड ऑफ एनी डायरेक्शन लाइक दिस वन और दिस वन दिस. ओके सो इनका जो रिजल्टेंट वेक्टर रहेगा. ओके सो वी आर अलाउड टू ऐड ओनली वन वेक्टर समथिंग लाइक इट इज वी ए एंड यू कैन ऐड दिस वेक्टर like either in the horizontal direction or in vertical direction. Okay, but its magnitude should be less than equal to n. Okay, and wo add karke you have to minimize the net resultant. Okay, so the like the answer is simple, just find the resultant. Okay, and now this is the projection on the x and y direction and like try to reduce each one of them. Okay, so try to reduce this one. So if it is greater than m, so it will be like this part will be now. So this is y, this is x. Okay, so this part is now x minus m. So try to reduce this part. If it is less than m, so then it will obviously be zero because it is better to reduce it to zero because we want to minimize the resultant right now. So similarly, do with y part. Okay, that's it. Okay. Suppose now, okay, I think your question ka solution clear hai na? I think this is pretty straightforward. एक बार बताओ लाइक आप प्लस वन लिख दो लाइक तुम्हें अगर इसका क्लियर है तो बिकॉज आई थिंक यू कैन डू दिस. ओके नाउ द लाइक द नेक्स्ट वर्जन ऑफ दिस प्रॉब्लम सपोज द वेक्टर्स आर नॉट लाइक द वेक्टर्स आर नॉट अलाइन टू हॉरिजॉन्टल लाइक दे आर गिवन यू आर गिवन सम रैंडम वेक्टर्स लाइक दैट And now तुम्हें पूछा है कि add one vector which is add one vector whose magnitude should be less than equal to m and minimize the resultant part. Okay, so is part two कैसे करोगे. So basically now the question is vectors are not aligned horizontally or vertically. It can be any random vector. Okay, in 2D space. Okay, and now you have to add one vector whose magnitude is less than equal to m and minimize the resultant. This part is a good one. So this particular a vector kaise add karo like a particular a vector ka basically kaise add karo. Suppose assume that this one is your resultant vector of remaining vectors एंड तुम्हें एक वेक्टर ऐड करना है सच दैट इसका मैग्नीट्यूड इज इक्वल टू m1 एंड r वेक्टर प्लस a वेक्टर मिनिमाइज हो गया। एनी थॉट्स इस पार्ट को कैसे करोगे? वेक्टर्स आर रैंडम ओके, लाइक वेक्टर्स तुम a वेक्टर को कैसे ऐड कर सकते हो? या सो द आंसर इज ट्राई टू ऐड इन द अपोजिट डायरेक्शन ऑफ रिजल्टेंट वन ओके, सो ट्राई टू ऐड इन दिस वे ओके। इफ इफ माय रिजल्टेंट वन हैज मैग्नीट्यूड लेस देन m, so basically I can add this complete one and make it zero, okay, minimum can be zero, okay, but if my magnitude vector has like resultant vector has r less than m, so I can only able to add only up to m, only m part, only m magnitude part, okay, so my then my answer will be r vector minus m, okay, so basically the answer is maximum of zero and r vector like resultant, okay, so this is answer in this case. कुछ डाउट किसी को? और लाइक इफ इट्स देयर लाइक राइट प्लस वन ओके, जैसे हिंट मिलता है फिर इसमें समझ the other version of the problem is this one. Okay, so the question is like that कि तुम्हें एक नंबर दिया है x, okay, and जिसका रेंज रहेगा वो maybe tends to 6, so x belongs to y and x was 6, okay. And if you can like suppose x is prime, okay, now question is you are allowed to change at most one digit in x, at most one digit in x. If x becomes prime then print s, okay, at most one digit in x. If it becomes a prime number, prime, then print s, otherwise no. Okay, the question is like that. Okay, you are allowed to change at most one digit. Okay, so basic and first observation that you can say, if x is prime already, okay, so at most one, right? So I don't need to change. I can directly print s. But if x is not a prime, okay. So what you can do? So observe that like x can have maximum 6 digits, right? So basically, so it can have maximum of 6 digits, okay? So try to change each one of them. So try to change this one. The most significant digit will vary from 1 to 9 because we are not allowed to change like most significant digit to 0, okay? Otherwise, like the length will decrease, okay? Length of the number will decrease. So change most significant digit from 1 to 9. If we can able to get a prime number by this, then it's good. If not, move to next one. Try to change it each one of the digits from like it will vary from 0 to 9. Try to this thing. Okay. So now the complexity, like now you are changing each digit, this one by 9 times, this one by 10 times. So maximum type complexity for you here will be like 10 to 5 plus 9 and 10 into 5. 10 into 5 plus 9, okay, which is around 60, okay. Now the question is, after changing the digit, if I got some number y, okay, so how to check whether y is prime or not, okay. So the other thing is that, observe that, like, so what is the maximum value of y that can be possible here, okay. So which is obviously 9 into 5, 9 into 6. 9 to 10 to 6, because like if you have this 6 number, like this one, if I change, okay, so like there is 7 number, sorry, so we have to be 6 plus 9, which is around 7, So if I change this 1 to 9, okay, if I change this 1 to 9, so that means the maximum value of y is 9 to 4, 6. Okay. So this is only one thing, okay. But if I see the other numbers, after this, what is the second possible value that I can get? Like second max possible value that I can get, which is 1900000. Okay, like changing this 129. Okay. So that means it is kind of around 200 sources. Like it is around 200 sources. Okay. So we can, and it is around 10 source 7. Okay. So actually we can store numbers of 10 source 6. Okay. Pre-compute the prime numbers easily using this sieve. Okay. And check for it. Okay. If it is 9 source 6 number, then it is obviously, we know that this is not a prime number because it is already visible by 10. Okay. So we can discard this particular number already. But for the remaining numbers, we can pre-compute the prime numbers and check for whether it is this transform by number is belong to this, is a prime number or not. We can maintain one hash array, okay, like similar to sieve, okay, and like what we used to do in sieve. Okay, so that's like you need to do only this thing only. Change each of the number. There are only 70 changes will occur at max, and for each one you can find. After doing pre-computation, for each change number, which is at least 70 numbers, you can find whether that number is prime or not in O of 1. Okay, but after pre-computation. Yes, Samjhai, kuch doubt? अगर समझ गया तो प्लस वन लिख दो, अगर नहीं समझा तो डाउट पूछो क्या है. ओके, या यू कैन डू दैट. तुम स्क्वायर रूट और प्राइम चेक कर सकते हो, बट ऑब्जर्व दैट द नंबर ऑफ टेक्स्ट इज 10 फॉर 6. ओके, सो लाइक योर टाइम कंप्यूटिव फॉर इन दैट केस विल बी first one is root n into 70, because there are 70 kinds of y here. Okay, 70, and whole will be then multiplied by t. Okay, so which is around 10 to the power 3 into 70 into 6. Okay, which will not pass in the limit. Okay, so to me actually pehle compute karne padenge, pre compute karne padenge, like prime numbers less than equal to less than equal to 206. For 9 into 10 for 6, for 9 million you can directly print more. Okay, like we know that like this is not a prime number. So for this, up to this limit, you can compute all the prime numbers and directly check whether that one is like particular number is prime or not, go off and directly. So this will reduce to off after pre-computation. 72. And the pre-computation will take log n time. Like something like, okay, the n is bigger, okay, which is 7 4 6. Okay, the next question. Okay, so this question, so basically you have given a three array P, get it R, and this is Q. These are three arrays that you have given. You have to find this particular sum. Okay, sum X. So x, okay. So x varies from 0 to a minus 1. Y varies from 0 to r minus 1. So this is actually length of the array, okay, pqr, small p, small r, small q. 0 divided by 1 q minus 1. Okay, so you have to find these particular sum. Px ry into qz, okay, qz plus ry. And there is one more condition, okay, which is like ry should be greater than px and so okay, it's like this is a this is kind of unit function or identity function, you can say. So like if x statement is true, then it will take value 1, otherwise it will take value 0. Okay, so this is kind of the function, okay, mathematical notation. If the internal expression is true, then it will take value 1, otherwise it will take value 0. Okay, so that means you have to find this particular sum, right, which is super b. Like, so you have to simplify this somehow. Okay, now the question is how simplify it. Okay, so the main thing that we need to see is that this particular condition, okay, this condition, look into this condition. Okay, so r y should be greater than both px and qz, right? So this gives us some idea. Okay, the first idea that we can get is that sort all three array. Okay, sort all three arrays. Okay, so now I have sorted all the three arrays. Now the question is how to again find this. Okay, so although that the main condition here, the common one is ry, right? Ry. So kind of we have to fix ry. Like if you can fix ry, so let's see what happen. Okay, like try to fix ry part. Okay, so fix ry. So that means fix the index y. And suppose this x and this z. Okay, so this is suppose x. Okay, like suppose x of that, px is greater than equal to ry, but px plus 1 is not. Px plus 1 is greater than ry. Okay, so that means x is the like that means x is actually upper limit for ry. Okay, like upper limit. Okay, and that means like all the elements from 0 to x is less than ry, but x plus 1 is not less than ry. Like ye ek limit mil gaya mujhe. Okay, similarly for z. Okay, so qz is less than ry and qz plus 1 is greater than ry. That means say or ek limit mil gaya. Okay, so that means and I fix y. So your particular x and y I can find using binary search, or you can maintain two pointer with running y. Okay, like you can do multiple things. Okay, multiple ways to find this x and z. So for fix ry, if you see the answer will be like answer including ry will be for all i from 0 to x, because all the numbers from 0 to x is less than ry. For all j belong to 0 to z, because all number from 0 to z is less than ry. Okay, we have to find this expression. Yahan tak kisko kuch doubt hai? Like this is actually the main part of the solution. किसी को कुछ डाउट हो तो लिखो, लाइक डाउट क्या है, अगर समझे तो प्लस में लिखो. ओके, अब ये क्वेश्चन इज हाउ टू गो फॉरवर्ड. ओके, फ्रॉम दिस के अगर तुम इसको सिंपलीफाई करोगे इस क्वेश्चन को, ये जो बेसिकली I equal to 0 to x, z equal to 0 to z, which is kind of like pi into आर वाई प्लस क्यू जे इंटू आर वाई प्लस आर वाई स्क्वायर प्लस पी आर इंटू क्यू जे. ओके सो दिस इज एक्चुअली एक्सपांशन. ओके अगर तुम इसको और सिंप्लीफाई करोगे सो यू कैन सी दैट आर वाई इज फ्रॉम जीरो टू एक्स दिस इज काइंड ऑफ पी आई इंटू आर वाई दिस इज कॉन्स्टेंट ओके विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू जे इंटू जेड प्लस वन. जेड प्लस वन क्योंकि बिकॉज दिस इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट तो ये जेड प्लस वन टाइम्स रहेगा बिकॉज दिस इज जीरो इंडेक्स. ओके दिस इज जीरो इंडेक्स इंटू जेड प्लस वन. ओके सेकेंड थिंग इज दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर पार्ट बिकॉज दिस जे इज कॉन्स्टेंट विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू आर सो इट इज अगेन जे वेरीज फ्रॉम जीरो टू जेड दिस जे इज कॉन्स्टेंट विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू आर दिस विल बी क्यू जे इंटू आर वाई into x plus 1. Okay, this is constant with respect to r, right? Now r y is constant with respect to both. So it will simplify x plus 1 into z plus 1 into r y square. Okay, now the only thing that we need to compute is basically this I equal to 0 to x j equal to 0 to z pi into qj. Okay now like ye iska simplification hota right this expression. Okay now the question is observe the statement. Okay so this one is simple 2 of n ho jayega right just x plus 1 plus z plus 1 to r square. Okay so this is done. Okay now observe this one so these two are constant. Okay and so this is kind of doing the prefix sum. Okay so this can be written in this way r y into z plus 1 this constant respect to r and summation over pi from 0 to x and this is actually the prefix sum right from 0 to x so that means if I pre-compute the prefix sum I can find it also like this expression also in O(1) right similarly for this one this constant respect to j that means I only have to find a prefix sum over q and I can like after pre-processing I can compute this particular value in O(1). Okay so this three part are there. Now this one so this is nothing but if you see like this one is nothing but a like this kind of multiplication like p0 plus p1 up to px into q0 plus q1 up to qz. Okay this is again a prefix sum. If I know the prefix sum to x z so I can directly multiply both the prefix sum and like I can find so that means for a fix I can find it in constant value constant time. So this like varying over the all I and j possibilities kind of doing this kind of thing p0 into px like multiplication of these two part this will cover all the value of this particular sum. So that means if I compute the sum as a pre-processing part, so I can also compute this part in O(1). So that means for fixed R y, I can compute this particular sum, this particular ugly sum in O(1), right? So that means I only need to iterate over y. If you use two-pointer approach, you can slide this x like forward. Or you can do binary search to find x and z. Okay, like there are multiple ways to do that. It's all depend on. कुछ doubt है कोई किसी को solution में? So you only need to simplify the expression और बस देखना था कि कैसे कर सकते हैं. कुछ डाउट है समझे तो प्लस में लिख दो है ओके Okay, so this is again a typical binary search problem. तुम्हें basically, I think अभी तुम्हें इस problem का solution समझ जाना चाहिए कि क्या रहता है, like तुम्हें एक array दिया complete, तुम्हें उसके server में decompose करना such that उसका इसको जो maximum value हो वो minimum हो, okay? So you can do binary search on answer and try to find that like whether it's possible to break into the like k or not. So the maximum value है वो like इस problem किसको doubt है क्या? This is again a like typical binary search problem. इस problem किसको doubt है? अगर है तो like बताओ, अगर नहीं है तो no लिखो actually. And this is again a very very typical binary search problem. Okay, तुम्हें बस answer over binary search over answer करना है, and then बस check करना है. It is possible to decompose into k part or not. Like we expect that up to this point you could able to solve this problem. Okay, so we can skip this problem. So this, I think, similar kind of problem is also there in the practice section, or I think. हाँ प्रैक्टिशन में है, आई थिंक सिमिलर कंडक्ट होगा, देख सकते हैं. एंड द लाइक द लास्ट प्रॉब्लम, so the problem is like that. You are given a grid. Okay. Sorry for the bad drawing. Just a second. Okay, so basically we are given a grid like that. Each one has some notation, like it is either a black cell or white cell. Okay, so suppose 0 is black, 1 is white. Okay, and suppose the cell is filled this way, like this. So now in each query, so you are given some query, Q queries. Again, look into the Q, size of Q. What is Q? Q is, okay, so there is, okay, Q is a size of 5, like, okay. And in each query, you are given some cell address or something like that, okay. So this is X, comma Y, okay. So with this particular cell as a center, you have to find the maximum size of square, okay, this maximum size of square such that, okay, I'm not sure, okay, so maximum size of square batana just at most k like also, okay. So with this particular x as a center, मुझे maximum size area of square बनाना है जिसमें at most k black cells हो. Okay, like before going forward, tell you one thing. If this side is a distance d, is a distance d from the center, okay, and also one thing, like yes, a particular square कंप्लीटली लाइक करना चाहिए ग्रेड के अंदर, आई थिंक ये कंडीशन है। आई थिंक वो लाइक करना चाहिए तभी वो स्क्वायर रहेगा साइज में। ओके ओके, सो सपोज मुझे एक चीज बताओ, सपोज एक पर्टिकुलर साइड एट डिस्टेंस डी है, एट डिस्टेंस डी है सेंटर से, तो ये चार एंड पॉइंट की वैल्यूज क्या रहेंगे? Like you can tell me proper direction का, अगर ये distance d है, so ये particular side पे जो last square रहेगा, यहाँ पे जो side पे lie करेगा, उसका distance d है, so d means the number of squares in between them, so distance between this and this one is one, because like direct subtraction, okay? तो ये चार का value क्या रहेगा? ये चार कॉर्नर पॉइंट्स के वैल्यू लाइक कोऑर्डिनेट्स करेंगे, बिकॉज़ ये डी है तो ये भी डी रहेगा, बिकॉज़ स्क्वायर है आल्सो एंड ये सेंटर है, तो डी डी, तो ये चार कॉर्नर पॉइंट्स के वैल्यू करेंगे, लाइक तुम चैट पे लिख सकते हो। सो डिस्टेंस इज बेसिकली नंबर ऑफ स्क्वायर्स इन बिटवीन देम, या राइट, सो इट इज एक्चुअली एक्स माइनस डी y minus d, then this is okay, this particular one will be x minus d and y plus d, this particular one will be x plus d and y plus d, and this one is x plus d and y minus d, right? सपोज तुम्हें क्वेरी इस टाइप की, लाइक इन द क्वेरी तुम्हें इस टाइप की क्वेरी, लाइक तुम्हें सेंटर पता है एंड तुम्हें जिस डिस्टेंस डी पता है, एंड तुम्हें भी बताना है कि ये पर्टिकुलर स्क्वायर में कितने नंबर ऑफ ब्लैक सेल्स लाई करते हो, ओके, तो ये तुम कैसे बता दोगे? नंबर ऑफ ब्लैक सेल्स जो इसमें इस पर्टिकुलर स्क्वायर में लाई करते हो तुम कैसे बता दोगे? या सो यू कैन यूज 2D प्रीफिक्स सम, 2D prefix sum, like तुम number of black cells का तुम take 2D prefix sum maintain कर सकते हो, and you can find this thing number of black cells lie within this particular square in O of one by using 2D prefix sum as a pre-processing part. By doing this thing in pre-processing, you can find this thing in O of one, right? Now again, for fix x y. If I increase d, the q x y d function also increase, right? तो यहाँ से तुम्हें क्या आइडिया मिला, like इसका सॉल्यूशन क्या होगा finally? तुम्हें at most के black cells का maximum area का square पता करना है, तो तुम इससे तुम्हें क्या आंसर आएगा? Yeah, right. So you have to do binary search on d, right? That's it, okay? Like तुम अगर पूरे प्रोसेस में प्रीप्रोसेसिंग में कर दोगे, नंबर ऑफ ब्लैक सेल्स विद इन दिस पर्टिकुलर स्क्वायर तुम ऑफ वन में पता कर सकते हो, ये चीज तुम्हें पता नहीं थी। अगर तुम्हें अगर ये चीज पता नहीं कि ओके सो लाइक लीनियर सर्च नहीं कंस्ट्रेंट लो, दैट मीन्स लाइक दी number of rows and number of columns are tensor for 3, okay, but the number of cells belonging to that particular square can be okay, so number of cells belonging to this one, okay, so this particular has the side 2d plus 1, okay, iska jo side hai wo 2d plus 1 hai, so number of square belonging to this square is 2d plus 1 square, okay, so that means it can go up to tensor 6 range, okay. अगर तुम तुम्हारी क्वेरी टेंशन 5 है, अगर तुम लीनियर सर्च करोगे तो वो काफी मतलब कॉस्टली हो जाएगा, बिकॉज क्वेरी टेंशन 5 है एंड इफ आई डू लीनियर सर्च ऑल दी नंबर्स ऑल दी सेल्स व्हिच अगेन कैन बी व्हिच अगेन लाइक क्वाड्रेटिक ओवर द साइड, ओके, वो टेंशन 6 रेंज में जा सकता है एंड लाइक मल्टीप्लीकेशन इज टू हाई, ओके, सो इट इज नॉट गुड आइडिया टू डू लीनियर सर्च. लाइक तुम्हें प्रीफिक्स सम मेंटेन करोगे तो ऑफ फॉर्म में तो एक क्वाड्रेटिक पार्ट हटा सकते हो, उससे ऑफ फॉर्म में हो जाएगा तुम्हारा. और कुछ डाउट किसी को? अगर समझ गए तो प्लस वन लिखो. ओके, लाइक तुम्हें इसमें और एक मतलब वो चीज हैंडल करनी पड़ेगी, लाइक ये जो चारों एंड पॉइंट है वो विद इन दी ग्रिड होने चाहिए, ये सब तुम्हें एक एक्स्ट्रा एक चेक कंडीशन लगाना पड़ेगा. ओके, अगर आप बाहर चले गए तो इट इज नॉट लाइक इट इज अननेसेसरी टू गो लाइक टू इंक्रीज लो वैल्यू. ओके, तो तुम उस समय चेक पहुंचे तो फॉल्स रिटर्न कर लोगे. ओके, तो कैंडा तू हर क्वेरी यहाँ पे ऑफ लॉग मैक्स ऑफ ना मीन ऑफ आर कॉमा सी में आंसर करूंगी, बिकॉज लाइक यही मैक्स एड हो सकता है मीन ऑफ आर कॉमा सी, लाइक जो भी रहेगा तो तुम्हारे ओवरऑल कंपटीशन क्यूब इनटू ये हो जाएगा. लाइक अगर इसका सोल्यूशन तो प्लस वन लिख दो प्लीज. ओके, ओके एक चीज तो मुझे दिख रही है यहाँ पे तुम्हारे कोर में गलती कि लाइक रीड द क्वेश्चन. ओके, लाइक तुम्हें क्वेश्चन में पूछा है द मैक्सिमम पॉसिबल एरिया, ये तो तुम आई थिंक यहाँ पे साइड प्रिंट करो एंड उसके बाद तुम यहाँ पे अच्छा वो ओके अच्छा राइट फिर सही है ये. ओके, यहाँ पे और एक चेक कंडीशन लगा के देखो एक्स माइनस मिड का, एक्स माइनस मिड लेस देन जीरो एंड वाई माइनस मिड लेस देन जीरो. आई थिंक ये मिसिंग है यहाँ पे. ओके, यहाँ पे चेक कंडीशन ऐड करके देखो, आई थिंक उससे पास होना चाहिए x minus mid less than zero, because अगर mid grid अगर x minus mid suppose less than zero हो रहा है तो यहाँ पे एक गलत memory access हो रहा है. okay, so वो kind of में कार्य जरूर दे देगा. I think okay part हाँ ये हो सकता है. okay, तो ये part एक बार try करो, ये एक check करके add करो. okay, and then अच्छा हाँ भी एक्चुअली सौरव तुम भी यहाँ पे एक एक्स्ट्रा चेक कंडीशन लगाओ ए बी सी डी पे. बिकॉज़ वो विद इन द सेल होने चाहिए एंड पॉइंट्स. ओके तो तुमने आर यू वो लिखा है. अच्छा वो विद इन द अच्छा अच्छा ये तो पहले से रहेंगे. ओके ये कंडीशन देखो. एक्चुअली सर तुम बेसिकली ये देखना चाहते हो कि तुम वाई को कहां तक एक्सटेंड कर सकते हो राइट. तो तुम वाई को एक्चुअली वाई माइनस वन सही है बट यहाँ पे सी माइनस वाई होना चाहिए राइट. नंबर ऑफ कॉलम माइनस वन द राइट साइड का एंड एक्स को तुम कहां तक एक्सटेंड कर सकते हो ये तुम्हें देखना है. तो तुम बेसिकली एक्स माइनस वन सही है बट अप साइड में like upside में it is x minus 1 but x minus 1 downside में it is c minus x sorry r minus x number of rows. I think ये यहाँ पे part गलत है ऊपर देख लेना. ये तुम r और c को गलत ओके एक बार देखो यहाँ पे try करके अगर figure wrong आता है एक बार forum में पूछ लो. और किसी को कुछ पूछना है अभी बता कि लाइक कितने क्वेश्चन पॉसिबल थे करना कितने कितना रेट करोगे अभी कॉन्टेस्ट को. ओके बाकी लोग तो बस कॉन्टेस्ट को ऑब्सॉल्व कर लेना क्योंकि काफी सीखने को मिलता है कॉन्टेस्ट को. क्वेश्चन इस तरह के डिजाइन करने की लाइक तुम्हें सीखने को मिले एंड तो बस आप सॉल्व करो। और किसी को कुछ पूछना है कि ठीक है, लाइक क्वांटिटी आप सॉल्व करते रहो, और कुछ भी डाउट है कि नहीं समझ में आ रहा कि तुम्हें लगा क्वेश्चन सही है बट नहीं कोड सही है बट रॉन्ग आंसर आ रहा है तो फोरम में पूछ सकते हो। ओके तो लाइक अभी सेशन यहीं पे एंड करते हैं।